said, give up the spirit of heaviness, and for exchange he will give you the garment of grace. Somebody shout hallelujah. But I want you to hear this. This is what the word was for tonight. Do this real quick. You're going to praise your way to your future because you're about to cause some things to happen tonight. Somebody shout hallelujah here. I promise you, by the middle, and I already said the second week of October, by the middle of October, many of your lives will have a significant change. Or somebody shout hallelujah. I said a significant change. Look at your next neighbor. By the middle of October, I won't look like what I went through. Matthew chapter 14, when Jesus had finished performing miracles with the loaves and the fish, he sent the multitude away, and he told the disciples, he said, I want you to go over to the other side. Say this, we're going over to the other side. Now, this is a little different from Mark chapter 4, when Jesus said, let us go to the other side. He was on the boat, but this time he sent them and he went to pray. Tell this to neighbor, get ready. We about to cross over, but in the midst of the crossover, you're going to see a miracle. And Mark 4, we've been talking about miracle in the midst of a storm. And by 4, you will find out when they crossed over, there was a storm that raged. Well, somebody shout hallelujah here. And the Bible said that Jesus was sleeping in the vessel. They woke him up and said, do you not care of all of this that's happening? And Jesus said, oh, ye of little faith. And he spoke to the storm and said, peace be still. But this is not what happened in Matthew 14. And it's the same account in Mark chapter 6. But the writer's writing differently. In Matthew 14, now watch this now. Jesus sent them ahead of them. And he said, cross over to the other side. He went to pray. Watch this now. The Bible declares that in the fourth watch of the night, there was a wind or a storm that was blowing. And the vessel was being tossed to and fro. But as the vessel were being tossed to and fro, they looked out, and it was about 3 a.m., and they looked out, and they saw something walking on the water. Y'all, they talking to me in here. And the Bible said that they thought it was a spirit or a ghost until they recognized it was Jesus. In Mark's account or his writing of the account, and it said that Jesus was almost about to pass them by. Tell me, talking to me here. Lo and behold, Peter speaks and he said, Lord, if that be you, bid me to come. Jesus said, come. The guy that said, come. Lo and behold, Peter, he grabs the side of the boat. And he proceeds to go over and step out to walk on water. But this is the key. We always talk about get out of the boat. But we never talk about the timing of getting out of the boat. See, what God wanted many of you to understand tonight is many of you are waiting for everything to be peaceful and calm before you step out. But if you look at the account, there was a storm going on. Yo, they talk to me in here. And Peter is getting out of the boat while there's a storm going. Y'all, they talking to me in here. So lo and behold, he gets out of the boat and he's walking on the water with Jesus. Come on, in the midst of a storm. Y'all, they talking to me here. Come on, tell you that's the neighbor. The perfect time to walk. That's when all hell is breaking out in your life. Watch this now. I can prove it. The Bible said that when he, see, some of y'all freak out, amen, when storms are raging, come on somebody. But that ain't the time. You must understand that that is the perfect time for a miracle to manifest in your life. When all storms are raging. So Peter is walking out here with Jesus, and there's a hurricane going on, and they walking on water. Y'all ain't talking to me in here. Watch this out. So lo and behold, I prove it. He looked at the waves, and then he looked at the wind, and because he looked at the storm that was raging, he began to sing. Tell you, it says, get your eyes off the storm. Come on, Tennessee, get off. Get your eyes off the storm. See, some of you been doing fine when you had your eyes on Jesus. But soon as you, your focus was diverted, and you begin to look at the situation again, you start sinking. Y'all ain't talking to me here. The Bible said that he called out to Jesus, and he said, Jesus, my old friend, Jesus, help me. Jesus reached, and he pulled Peter back up. And the Bible said that they two together got in the ship. When they got in the ship, guess what happened? The storm ceased. What God wants you to understand in this season and this time, don't wait till everything has lined up. Don't wait for the peace. Don't wait for the calm. The reason why all hell is breaking out in your life right now is because God wants to show you a miracle in the midst of this storm. And the title of the message is this. Look at your neighbor. Say, neighbor, when the winds are blowing and the waves are raging, guess what, neighbor? Walk it out. I need somebody to go ahead and walk out into your future.